The story is about the grime scene in London and largely focused around East London, where grime music was born. What distinguishes grime music is the speed. It's 140 beats per minute. It appealed to me because I didn't know anything about it, and so for me to get an opportunity to photograph something that normally I wouldn't access was really exciting. It wasn't an easy world to get access to. A lot of them have a big web presence, and this was the thing that was hard to kind of untangle, because everybody can hide behind a website that makes you look like a global superstar. Once I found them, it was a real person living in quite modest environments. I've been working with them at a few different crews. So there was one called the Slow Dem crew, another called the Collective, and another young guy called Squints. The grime world seems to me like it's a pretty macho culture, but I've been starting to work with one interesting artist called Lady Shocker. She is a woman, first of all, and she's also gay, and she's had to deal with a lot of criticism about being gay, so she's a very tough character. One of the things that they do is they will have things called clashes. They could be like, you know, inches from each other, trading proper insults, but then roaring their heads off after it. You know, it's quite a weird thing to see. One of the main challenges on the job was working in very, very low light. A lot of grime takes place in darkly lit studios, darkly lit nightclubs, and I wanted to try and record it in that way. I wanted to get some of the atmosphere of it, and so I was trying not to use any flash if possible. All of the artists that I met are ambitious and they want commercial success. Very few of them were making money full-time from music. One of the most memorable things is a scene from a radio set. There was a group of young guys all wrestling the mic off each other to spit their bars, which they call it. Afterwards, one of the young guys who was stocky, had the hood on, we were talking about what he does, and he was telling me that he's studying astrophysics at King's College. What I would like to show is really a little look into the world of grime and just how impressed I've been with the passion and the work ethic of these grime artists. They're completely dedicated to their music and they're pushing every day to make things happen.